I spent the last 2 weeks figuring out how I can turn a Figma design into a fully functional website, ideally without writing a single line of code. I've tested everything from Figma plugins to website builders to AI chatbots, and I finally found the perfect solution. It's called V0. In this video, I will show you how to use V0 to get from this Figma design to a fully functional website in just a couple of minutes. And if you stick around, I will share the entire chat I had with V0 so you can see the exact prompts I use and apply them to your own projects. By the end, you will know exactly how you can do this by yourself. So let's dive in. This is the Figma design I have created in one of my last videos. And I will break down this design into sections. So I will just take screenshots of the hero section, the problem section, the solution section, etc., and drop them into the chatbot. So let me quickly take a few screenshots here. Alright, now let's head over to V0 where we can drop the images in and you can see which prompts I'm using to build the website. So the prompt I will start with is, I have a landing page design made in Figma and I want to turn it into a fully functional website. And I'm giving it the prompt that I will provide the design in sections. And I'm also giving the information that we got 9 sections here. So now I will take the screenshot from the hero section and drop it here into the chat. So let's see how the chat is doing. And the cool thing is you can actually see how it's doing everything in real time. So it's writing the code, the landing page file is here, and it's giving you a preview how the page is looking right now. And as you can see, it's doing already pretty well. We have the landing page, the bold headline, and it's using placeholders for all the images. Some spacing are a little bit off, but I will fix that in a minute. Let's continue with the next section. I also noticed that we are missing the navigation, so I will add a prompt where I say, hey, you missed something here, so let's add it back to our code. I think it's pretty cool that you can see how it's doing this in real time. And you can see the navigation is now there. And just to give you a reference, this is the section we just built with V0. Let's see it in full screen. This is looking pretty good already. The spacing is still a little bit off to the left and right side, but that's something we will fix later on. Of course, every web page needs a hosting provider, and that's where the sponsor of today's video comes in, Cloudways. Cloudways is a powerful and easy to use managed hosting service. So whether you're building a simple site or fully fledged SaaS applications, Cloudways makes sure your website is always up to speed, secure, and scalable. So they handle all the server-side work like automatic backups, security, and of course, scalability. I've made a comparison between my current provider and Cloudways for my website, and it turns out Cloudways is like 10 times faster than my current provider, which is kind of crazy. If you need reliable, fast hosting with great performance, check out the link in the description to learn more about Cloudways. Let's move on to the next section. In the next section, we got a video here, but I will tell the chat that we will use a placeholder image here as well. What's a little bit weird is that it's building the entire website every time from scratch. So we are again seeing how it's building the hero section. But I mean, as long as it adding the new section into the website, I don't really mind. Okay, this is the first time I think it messed up a little bit. The text is centered, which is not in the design, and the hand is pointing upwards, which is also wrong. But I actually like how it has placed the time it takes for the video to watch at the bottom, and it has used a placeholder for the video, which is also great. So let's quickly fix the issues we have in this section here. Let's see how that turns out. So it's still a bit off, the text is somehow moved a little bit to the right side, but the hand is pointing down now, which is perfect. Let's quickly align the headline with the text so we can move on to the next section. Awesome, it has fixed the issue on its own with just text prompting. I haven't written a single line of code yet. We still got 5 more sections to go, so let's move on to the next section. So what I'm doing here is I'm reminding the chat that we want to keep placeholders for the images because we got now a section where we have 3 images in the design. Okay, it kind of messed up and lost the rest of the landing page. So what I will do now is prompt him to get them back, basically. I hope we didn't lose what we have built until now, so let's see. Okay, the chat has realized that we have missing sections, and I think we have all the sections now back, as well as the new section in here, which is great. Okay, we can move on. The next section is quite simple, so I don't think the chat will mess this up, but let's see. Okay, it looks a bit different from the design, but I actually don't mind. It looks fine. But again, the rest of the components are gone. To be honest, I think we can just move on with the next sections. I don't think the chat has lost information. Okay, I only got like one message left for today, but that's also cool because I could build the entire website till now without paying anything for it. Actually, what I will do is I will take the rest of the design and put it into the chat and see if the chat can build the entire remaining part of the website. So what I will do now is drop in the entire rest of the landing page and prompt it to build the page. Actually, let's also say that we are missing the previous sections here. Okay, fingers crossed that this will work and we can get a final landing page out of it. It looks pretty good. It's starting off with the navigation, so I have high hopes. Honestly, it's so cool to see this in real time, how it's building the entire website. And just to give you a reference, I think this would take me a couple of hours to build with coding. Okay, it seems like the pricing section is there, as well as the call to action here at the bottom. And we also got a footer, which is pretty awesome. And also the social media icons here. Now it says we have zero message remaining, but still we got a landing page file here, which is awesome. Okay, so let's make this page public. What we need to do is go to share. We can click on public with link or just publish it. And as you can see, I already got a URL, can type it in, and there we go. We have a landing page for our AI teleprompter. It's missing a few things here and there, but this is actually pretty awesome. I could build this with just text prompts. And the cool thing is we have actually the code here, so I can copy this over to my code editor and make adjustments if I wanted to. Or we can wait another day to work on the page, or honestly just upgrade to the pro plan. And of course you can also download the entire codebase and use ChatGPT to ask questions and fix styling issues. But apart from that, it's pretty cool that we can build something like this without writing a single line of code. I've added a link to the page in the description below if you want to check it out. And just like that, we went from a Figma design to a fully functional website without writing any code. I'm going to include the entire chat I had in the description below. If you don't know what to put on your website or how to design a landing page, you should check out this video. That video breaks down step by step how to design a landing page optimized for sales. And it's where I created the design you saw in today's video. If this video was helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And as always, if you have any questions or you want me to cover a specific topic, leave a comment below. That's it from my side. See you in the next one. Bye.